Oh, there we go. Just give me. There we go. Come and sit here. And tell me your name first of all.
Lorraine.
Lorraine. And what do you want to fix, Lorraine? You wanted to say everything.
Yeah. I did.
I heard that. I'm not telepathic, but I just felt everything.
Well, to start with, I had a fall just over a month ago, and I've had two knee replacements, and I fell and landed on my left knee, which then got an infection. I've got arthritis, pain everywhere, and I've had enough. And I had an operation 20 years ago, and digestive problems ever since as well.
So I'm going to explain why. You're going to feel a lot better in a few minutes, all right? But when we're feeling fed up, guess what we do? We're fed up. Guess what we do? We eat. Mm. Yeah, and we put on weight because we're fed up.
Fed up.
Yeah. And the food tends to get stuck. Look, have you ever noticed that anybody that's ever done a diet will probably know this, is that you can eat letty sleeps for like 3 weeks and not lose any bloody weight. Mm. It's not just about calories, is it? Yeah? I can look at a chocolate bar and put an inch on my hips. Right, so calories is definitely a factor, but there's other underlying things, and it's about the extent to which we're willing to let stuff go. When I want to lose weight, somebody suggested a really silly thing, which was like, go get food poisoning. No, that's not what I'm going to suggest. But usually there's something emotional that I'm holding on to that I need to release. You've got a lot of emotion to come out, yeah?
I thought I was doing it though, but it can't have been.
No, we've got more to come out.
It started when I was born.
Right, so the first thing we need to understand absolutely that mum nearly dying was not your fault.
Yeah.
All right, so now if we can fix that one, because what happens is the energies that we hold onto are a bit like dandelion roots. Have you ever pulled out a dandelion root? You have dandelions, but anyway, if you pull it out and you don't get all of it, it'll regrow.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so you've got to dig right the way down and get the core thing. If there's anything that happened right at birth, that's the core thing. And if we can fix that, everything else goes and falls away. Cool. So I'm going to explain to you why it wasn't your fault. Okay.
You're not that powerful.
I know. But Dad clearly thought you were. This is called a reframe. This is a reframe. I work with something called NLP, neuro-linguistic programming. Yeah. NLP isn't why I get the results I do. It is a divine healing that comes through. But along the way, I got NLP, which is useful. And so Dad must have thought you had huge power. You've never thought of it that way, have you?
No.
He must have been quite scared of you.
Mm-hmm. Well, we got on well, though.
You would have done.
With Dad.
Dad just couldn't cope with his emotions at the time, your mum.
Mm.
There's a feeling that she lost a lot of blood. That's the feeling, is that she lost a lot of blood. Do you know much about that?
I don't really know. No. I didn't really talk about it.
Yeah.
Mm.
Okay. Right. So, let's do some healing. Right. Now, as I do this healing, you guys are going to help. Mm. All right? We're going to do some sound healing. Okay, so, all your arms and your legs. And each show I like to do something a little bit different that we've not done before. We've never done this before on any event. So we're going to use, it's a South African song. And
we're all getting a little bit older, and memory's not as good as it probably used to be, unless you take the purple powder, and then it's amazing. So, it's a song with one word. Yes, yes. And the word is Nima. So, like Nima. 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 All right, and the song goes like this. Nima, Nima, Nima. Your turn.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
Beautiful. Keep it going.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
Keep it going.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
Keep the sound going, and I'm going to
Nima, Nima, Nima.
So in South Africa,
Nima, Nima,
the song is used to cradle a baby to sleep.
Nima, Nima,
I want you to imagine Nima, as a baby in your arms.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
So you just imagine that you're rocking her
Nima,
like a baby.
Nima,
and singing
Nima,
to her. That's just the most beautiful soul.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
And she's so blessed.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
So precious.
Nima, Nima. Nima, Nima,
how precious is she that defied all the odds to be here?
Nima, Nima, Nima. Nima, Nima, Nima.
Keep the sound going.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
Tracy, I'm going to get you to do a different tune.
Nima,
same words, but different tune. Melody.
Nima, Nima, Nima.
brethren. We are all absolutely equal, but we haven't had an equal start in life. But we all have access to an infinite amount of love and goodness within us. As we bring our awareness into our heart centre, we can transform our bodies, our lives, our finances, our relationships, and our planet. When you bring your awareness into the silence, it's why churches and sacred places are silent. When you bring your awareness into the silence, there is nothing for the mind, the ego, to grasp. And it realizes its own true nature and returns home. Notice the silence. In your awareness. I talked earlier about how God was everywhere and God was invisible and that God was not a thing. The silence is also a no thing, so I reckon God's in the silence too. God's in the stillness, the silence, and the spaciousness. And when we bring our awareness to any of those three no things, we start to feel very differently. There's less chatter in our heads. We no longer feel like we have to fix the world, or ourselves, or the planet. Everything simply is, and we simply are. All each of you has to do is be here in this moment. This moment is all that really exists. The past, what you think of as a past, is a previous now that you recall or not in this moment. What you think of as future is a mind projection of what may or may not happen. The only bit that's real is this moment. All you've got to do is bring your awareness to this moment and notice how you feel. And keep feeling your feelings. Make decisions that make you feel better. And avoid thoughts and situations that make you feel worse. Okay. Can I get everybody now to open your eyes and we're just going to check in and see how you're feeling? How are you feeling? Should we get you walking around to see?
That's probably a good idea, yeah.
Right. So this side's good?
Yes, it is.
Right, brilliant. So you'll sit back there and I'll move my chair around the room.
The circulation is not quite working right on this side.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah. Right, so let's go back. So the brain is in two halves. Do know that? The brain is actually in two separate, entirely separate parts. If you want to know more about that, see a TED Talks with a lady called Dr. Jean Bolt. She studied the brain and mind for her whole life, and she shows you a human brain. It's in two halves. And so the left brain, logical, analytical, considered logical, analytical, there's more of a crossover than we're led to believe, but linear in its thinking, is wired to the right side of the body. Now, what I'm going to get you all to do, because I like this to be interactive, is just close your eyes, arms uncrossed, feet on the floor. I want you to notice left side, right side, which is stronger for you? Where is lighter or heavier? Where has got more energy or less energy? Or do you feel equally balanced? They need to in your auric field to balance the right and the left sides better. And just observe what happens within you. Notice in particular any sensations you have, any colours you see, or any insights, flashes of insight you have. You're all getting flashes of insight all the time. The only problem is you're listening to your head too much, not noticing your flashes of insight. Now, when I work with you on your right side, the energy that I've got there is very protective and very loving. And this energy wants to protect and look after people, family especially. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You're like a mother hen that wants to look after the little chicks. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Now, this is the thing. Each of you would not be the amazing human being you are now without all those things that have happened to you. You didn't get to where you are now by having only good things happen. You grew most through the adversity and the challenges. Our children need adversity and challenge and hard times to help them develop. So we shouldn't protect our children from consequences. We shouldn't protect our partners from consequences. We can be there to support them dealing with their consequences that they've created through their choices this lifetime. But we don't want to do it for them. If we do it for them, we pay the price, because it takes energy, awareness, time, financial resources away from the issues that are our issues that we should be addressing. And guess what? They're going to get that lesson in another form. And there'll come a time where you can't help them out anymore. You haven't got the time, the energy, the resources to do so. So, whenever a situation arises in somebody's life, be very, very clear about whose issue is that. Do not take onto your shoulders or into your energy field somebody else's lesson, because you will truly not help them. You can support them. You can be there to lend an ear, to encourage and support, but they must learn their lessons. Okay. What happened in your energy field as I gave that instruction? Could you feel it all shifting?
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How are you feeling about that?
Good.
It feels good?
Good.
Right. Now have a little walk. That's a lot better, isn't it?
There's still work to do.
You've still got work to do.
How's it feeling?
I'm feeling more balanced.
Yeah, awesome. And they're going to keep on working with you 21 days. Give a round of applause.